type 2 diabetes is often associated with what we call insulin resistance, meaning that your body makes insulin, but it doesn't work as well. Risk factors for type 2 diabetes include family history. So we think about a first degree relative, mom, dad, brothers, sisters, giving a patient about a 50% risk for getting type 2 diabetes during their lifetime. We also know that type 2 diabetes is associated with weight. So for our larger patients, there would increase risk. Most commonly, patients with type 2 diabetes will be diagnosed with symptoms of high blood sugar. So they may be feeling thirsty, drinking lots of fluids, urinating a lot. They're often having blurry vision when the blood sugars get high. They also may be feeling fatigued. It can cause weight loss. In a lot of cases, patients are now being diagnosed by a blood test called a hemoglobin A1C. I think we're, as physicians, getting much better at screening patients who are at risk for diabetes. So this is being caught earlier, and I think that's incredibly important because the earlier we can catch this, the better we can move forward with treatment and help prevent the complications of diabetes. At UVA, we have many providers that treat patients for type 2 diabetes. We have a shared program with the Diabetes Education and Management Program, where we have certified diabetes educators as well as dietitians to help patients learn about their disease and management. It can be a really complex and confusing time for patients when they get a new diagnosis. So that group does a fantastic job in helping patients understand so that they can be empowered and do well in managing their diabetes.